Hey guys, coming to you from out front here, and I thought I'd show you a little closer look at one of my cigar box guitars. I kind of did a video before and showed all of them at once, but I thought we'd take a little more in-depth look at one and show you how it's made, that kind of stuff. And I brought it outside so maybe the lighting would be a little better, hopefully. But and this is my Arturo Fuente model, and this is completely hand-built. Now, and I'll show you some of the features here. As you can see, this tailpiece here, this is actually a kitchen cabinet hinge, and then, you know, that's just bolting on there as like a tailpiece. And then the, you know, I drilled four holes back here, equidistant holes, so that we could put the strings through there and everything, and made sure they were nice and smooth and everything, so they wouldn't cut the strings. This part back here is a trunk handle, you know, off of a big like steamer trunk, and I just took the handle portion out, took the plate, flipped it over, and then put this threaded rod in there and use that as a bridge, and it works pretty well. And if you look, hope you can see, I just, you know, I kind of use what's around, and I put some spacers in there and these screws, and then you can you know, swap them out, shim it up and down, so that you can set the bridge height exactly how you want it, so your action's just the right height and everything. The humbucker pickup here is like a Fender style humbucker, and just like on any guitar, this screw underneath this plate, there's a spring on that screw, and then it goes to the bottom of the pickup, so you can turn the screw in and out to raise or lower the position of the humbucker there. And then the thing surrounding it there, as you can see, is just like a solid brass switch cover, you know, like for a light switch or an outlet. And I just cut it out to make it fit correctly around the pickup there. And it seemed to work out really well. And also I'm able to, through this, since this is all metal assembly, I was able to actually internally ground these strings just for safety and that kind of thing. And then, you know, underneath here, there's a Fender 500K volume pot, I believe, if I remember correctly. And up here for a sound hole cover, we've got a closet pole socket, and, you know, just like what you put in your closet to, you know, to hold the dowel rod in so you can hang your clothes up and that kind of stuff. And then you can see that I put, you know, your fancy little brass box corners, which actually does make it a little more durable when you're banging it around. Keeps it from getting all bashed up on the corners, and it looks kind of neat too, I think. And I always try to build them whenever possible, lay everything out the best I can so you can still see the label and everything when you're doing it. And even like the, when I brought the fretboard over, I tried to cut it out so you could still see all that, so it kind of look nice as well. The fretboard is made of red oak, and those frets, as I mentioned in the other video, those are actually the little stainless steel strips that come with a windshield washer blade, or windshield wiper blades rather. And I cut each one, ground them down, rounded them, everything, and then I set them in there. And I cut the slots, believe it or not with a fret saw, but with a hacksaw. I've got a little mini hacksaw I use, and just through practice I've gotten where I can eyeball it and get them very nice and level. And you can see how well it plays by, you can check some of my videos, like of my nephew playing it and that kind of stuff, and you can see that it's fully functioning, and those frets do just fine. And they haven't really worn down at all. That stainless steel is very tough. The neck itself is made, and you actually in this light you can still see a little line there. It's actually made of three pieces of wood. Two strips there, and then a third larger piece of red oak there, and I laminated that all together, sanded it down, and it's very stout, plenty strong for four strings obviously. And then up here you can see that I just used a brass bolt, you know, for your nut up here, and that seems to work really well. And with these, I use these little brass eyelets as like string retainers, and then in the center here I actually did use a roller string retainer, or string tree, whatever you want to call it, and but that just makes sure that your strings stay in place well, and it works good. And I used a pretty good style, these are a Ping brand tuner, which, you know, not the most expensive tuners, but they're plenty good, and they've worked out real well. And I got some little brass hooks here for to hook a guitar strap on. On the back, you can see I wrote the name of my company and signed it. And that's all hand painted in what they call black adder script, which is like pirate writing. And then I took a kick plate from a door and cut a little panel. And then there's a cutout underneath that so that you can get to all the electronics. And, you know, I was trying to think ahead in case there was ever a problem. And you just got to remove those four screws and you can get in there and do any kind of work you need. And because you can see that that corresponds with the location of the jack and the volume pot and everything. So, and I mean, these guitars have proved to be real durable. Like I said, I've shipped them out all across the United States and I haven't had any complaints. Everybody's been having a good time with them. And we think they're a lot of fun too. I'll just plug this into this. I just got like a cheap old, I mean, what do you call an amp? It's like a karaoke machine. I'm going to plug it in and just show you that it does make noise here. And, and the strings, it's a four string, just to be different. And just so you know, it's utilizing the middle four strings, of a standard electric guitar set. Okay. So you got your, A, D, G, and B strings. This particular one's tuned to an open G. Actually, I think I've got them tuned G, D, G, B as you go across there. And, but I mean, there's a variety of ways you can tune them. Hey, Jordan, you want to help me out here for a second? But anyway, I just thought we'd take a closer look at one. I'm going to hand the camera over to Jordan, just plug it in. And I'm just going to play a few seconds just so you can hear it. Like I said, don't judge the sound quality by this amp. I would turn it down. Set up for really easy slide play, and four strings is all you need to do that. So anyway, thanks for taking a look at it, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.